All right, I'm Jamal Barber. I'm a printmaker, artist, and podcaster. That's what I do. You know, you're a little kid and you don't know how to handle stuff. And then kind of one day you just draw and it feels good. And so you do it the next day and it feels good. And you know, 35 years later, you wake up and the only way you know you can express yourself is through art. I went to college to get a degree in business, but I took this first drawing class and I was like, yeah, I'm changing my major to art. I do like it too much to not do it. And I think that's where most artists fall. It's like eventually you're like, I can't imagine doing anything else. So how do I make it work? That's usually what it is, yeah. The legend of Jamal goes, I went to Binders for watercolor and more paint. I used to do watercolors and acrylics, so I went for more paint and stuff. And I saw a screen printing demo like there at Binders. And you know, it's one of those things, like as soon as I saw it, I was like, that's it. Like that's what I had the idea about all the things I could do like with this process. And I think for printmaking, especially screen printing, because it's very like process specific. You do this to get this, to get this, and then you can do a print. Like it's so much stuff that gotta line up. But once you understand the philosophy, inside of that is so much other stuff you can do. And so that intrigued me. And that actually let me focus, because I could get lost in the painting. You can't just carve forever, because you won't have anything left. So it's not like that's an option for you. So I think it's the process of printmaking, like going through that process of teaching myself screen printing, really. Like I'm really self-taught in most printmaking processes. And that's the desire to do it is really the only thing you needed. But I think the process is so like a warm blanket when you're doing stuff. It's like comforting to know I can't go too far. The one thing that impacts me more than anything is my feeling about blackness. And so that's always like at the heart of like a lot of stuff that I see, how I'm interpreting, reinterpreting, contextualizing blackness, like in everything that is, in a much more expansive like light. Because I started off, when I started screen printing, I was like, if I'm gonna do this and spend all my money on buying all of this printmaking stuff, like I'm just gonna do, when I close my eyes, whatever I see is what I'm gonna do. I start off with just like a blank piece of wood. If you rolled up and ink it, it would just be a flat color with nothing in it. But then I add the light, I add the movement, I add the texture, I add all of those things. And then you end up with something that speaks to you. And what surprises me a lot is it speaks to other people about the experience of blackness. It's not just me feeling this way in my own body, but it's us as a collective, and somebody is latching on to the exact same things that I'm latching on. And that you're not alone out here, that it's somehow it's a voice that connects us, and it's being revealed through, like, you know, a piece of wood. You know what I'm saying? Like it all starts there. It's like wood, ink, and paper. That's all I need to say something. I create mostly because I have to. And on like really good days, when I'm really feeling good, I create because I think the world needs what I have to say. I don't feel like that every day. but you know, every once in a while I do a piece and like, okay, this is saying something that's adding to the culture. That's put something in the zeitgeist that hopefully people can see and cut through the noise. Hopefully, like on my best days. On my worst days, I just need something to do, you know. And I take that. It happens. What really started me like considering the professional seriously I read a book about Romare Bearden in high school, and his work spoke to me in a profound way about what it means, what it looks like to be Black, what it means to be Black, how you exist in that struggle. And hopefully that's what I can do for somebody else. I don't know, you know, lofty goals, like you shoot high, but that's what I want to do. I want people to know I was here. I'm Jamal Barber, printmaker, artist, podcaster. This is my voice, and this is my life.